According to former prosecutor and legal expert Glenn Kirchner, it appears that Jim Jordan pretty much, almost definitely, broke the law. And not just New York state law, but possibly violated the Constitution with his efforts to have the House Republican Party interfere with Alvin Bragg's ongoing prosecution at this point. We can't even call it an investigation anymore. It's a forthcoming prosecution of Donald Trump. Here's what Kirchner said recently on his legal podcast. Under our law, a person is guilty of obstructing governmental administration in the second degree when that person intentionally prevents or attempts to prevent a public servant from performing an official function by means of intimidation, physical force, or interference. That is precisely what Jim Jordan has done and is doing. So Jim Jordan, of course, as the chair of the House Judiciary Committee, is still pressuring Alvin Bragg to turn over information, to come and testify. And Bragg's office has pushed back last week in a letter. They accused Jordan of acting with basically unlawful political interference is the phrase that they used. But Jim Jordan's not stopping. Jim Jordan says this: the New York County District Attorney's unprecedented prosecutorial conduct requires oversight to inform the consideration of potential legislative reforms that would, if inactive, insulate current and former presidents from such politically motivated state and local prosecutions. So what he's trying to say is, I want to make it to where no former president can be prosecuted by state or local authorities, which, of course, is outside the legal possibility for Jim Jordan, because it's, as Kirchner points out, unconstitutional. It would be a violation of the 10th Amendment, as the federal government cannot interfere with a state-level prosecution. So Jim Jordan says that, hey, listen, I'm just trying to put pressure on Bragg because I want to see if I need to draft legislation protecting every former president that ever existed or will ever exist. Kirchner points out that, yeah, the 10th Amendment basically says you can't do that. Like, I don't know if you've heard of this thing Jordan called the Constitution, but it exists, and it exists to protect us from tyrants like yourself and, of course, Donald Trump. But Jim Jordan thinks he's got an ace up his sleeve, and last week made what I've called the dumbest decision he's ever made in his political career, and he subpoenaed Mark Pomerantz, the former prosecutor with the Manhattan DA's office who famously resigned a year ago after he said Bragg refused to come forward with indictments against Donald Trump for potential financial crimes. Pomerantz has said that he and Cy Vance, the former prosecutor, along with Kerry Dunn, the other prosecutor who also resigned, we had the indictments written up. Like, they were literally ready to be filed against Donald Trump. Bragg came in, decided not to do it. And Jim Jordan, for some reason, thinks it's a good idea to now have Pomerantz come into Congress and testify about that? Like, hey, Mark, come on in and tell us about all those other crimes that Donald Trump didn't get prosecuted for that you think he should have been prosecuted for. So that's not going to end well for Mr. Jordan or Mr. Trump, but that's what Jim Jordan wants to do because he is so desperate to put some kind of pressure on the Manhattan DA's office, which, again, he has no authority over whatsoever, but he's willing to violate New York state law. He's willing to violate the Constitution. And by subpoenaing Trump, he's apparently willing to humiliate, or excuse me, subpoenaing Pomerantz, he's willing to humiliate Trump. So there's nothing that Jim Jordan's not willing to do. It's just that not a single bit of it makes any sense. One of today's video sponsors is Private Internet Access VPN. Right now, they have an amazing offer for our Ring of Fire viewers. Go to piavpn.com/ringoffire and you can get 83% off for 3-year plans plus 4 months free. A VPN is a virtual private network that shields your information from unwanted parties on the internet. Think of it like a Halloween costume. It's still you, but no one can see that unless you let them. Using a VPN will shield your IP address, your browsing history, and other personal data from those who would use it maliciously, and from companies that want to track your every move.
It also provides an incredible layer of protection when using public Wi-Fi, like in an airport or a coffee shop. If you're using these connections without a VPN, your data could be vulnerable to all sorts of threats that VPNs do a great job of minimizing, or in some cases, outright eliminating. Private internet access has 50 servers in 50 US states. Need to look like you're surfing the web from Oklahoma? We got an IP for that. Do you need to visit a website that can only be accessed within Alaska's borders? Got an IP address for that too. With IP addresses available in all 50 states, you're gonna avoid sporting event blackouts if your state's local network opts out of the rights to televise the game. You're gonna be able to access local websites which are blocked outside of state borders, including local news stations and online banking details. And you're gonna be able to watch television premieres before they show up in your time zone. It's also compatible with all major streaming services, so you can browse location-restricted content that would otherwise be off limits to you. So go to piavpn.com/ringoffire and take advantage of the special offer. Get 83% off for the 3-year plans, and that brings it all down to $2.03 a month. And you also get 4 months of VPN protection for free. Plus, signing up for private internet access is risk-free. There's a 30-day money-back guarantee, and their highly skilled customer support team of experts is available 24/7. So make sure to subscribe today.